some of the information which you got under RTI, it's very difficult to get from Tamil Nadu government information to RTI.
And we still haven't got.
No, we got, but for, like, say, the percentage of success will be about 5%.
Right.
You have to go on a first appeal, then you have to go on a second appeal to the State Information Commissioner. The State Information Commissioner is appointed by the government, so you know how it works. Anyway, we got enough information, like we got audit reports of at least 50 temples, major temples.
And we have application before the Supreme Court asking for external audit of the institutions of these three states.
See, you must remember, there is no external audit for the temples in Tamil Nadu, whether it gets 20 crore income or 5,000 income.
Correct.
There is no external audit from 1976, number one. Number two, from RTI, you can really find out how these people's minds think, what all they do with the temple money, where is the property gone. Like in 1986, Tamil Nadu temples had 5.25 lakh acres of agricultural land. Right now, they say we have 4.75 lakh acres of agricultural land. Where did the 50,000 acres go? And in today's real estate value, this 50,000 acres would be like,
correct,
at least 10,000 crores. Only Tamil Nadu. Only Tamil Nadu. And Andhra Pradesh has got more lands than Tamil Nadu for temples. And under RTI, we came to know, I'll just take one more minute.
Please.
We came to know that there is one temple in southeast corner of Tamil Nadu called Vedaranyam Temple. The temple was actually administered by Sri Lankan Jaffna Tamils because it's only 60 kilometers across the sea. They had built for this temple over one century 17,000 acres of land, and many of them are salt pans. The central government has 2,400 acres of the salt pans, and they are giving, guess how much per acre per annum, the central government to the temple? Rupees 2.
Sir, also share with them the realization of lease revenue.
I'll just give you an example. 29 crore square feet. In Delhi, you say square yards, but they're square feet of sites. The sites have the advantage of being within the village, unlike agricultural lands, or within the town, or within the city. In Chennai, in one side, you have a area called Boat Club Road, which is the most expensive area in Chennai. On the other side, there are 305 grounds. Of land belonging to Kapalishwara Temple. As per the official valuation, for each ground per month, the rental is 3,75,000. But for the 305 grounds, government is realizing 3,000 rupees per month. You know, if we get the 3 lakh per ground per month, there need not be any Hindu poor child paying for their education across 1 mile of the temple.
Here's the charity
funny part. We are denied.
Correct. And I'll just to add to this. Each time you go to the government asking for funds for establishment of Veda schools or anything which is meant for keeping those traditions alive, they say, paisa nahi hai. Kahan se hoga? This is what you're doing. If you wanted to realize the amounts, you could have done so. In fact, sir, shared with me.
I missed the point.
Right.
Tamil Nadu government, with all these properties, 4.75 lakh acres, 29 crore square feet of land, and the 22,000 buildings, they are collecting about 80 crore rupees per annum. And to do that, they are taking administrative and audit fee, about 120 crores. That means temples are making a loss of 40 crores. Where does the 40 crore come from? From us, the Hundi money and the Archana ticket money.
Not just that. Yeah. What they